Julius AI is an absolute game changer in the world of data analytics with AI. It's like having an experienced data scientist that does data manipulation, data visualization, simply by using natural language as you would do in ChatGPT. Together, we'll go through a real project using Julius AI, and you'll see how powerful it is. Julius AI is free to start, so you can just go on their website, sign up, and test it for yourself. Let's dive into the tutorial. Okay, so here we are now on Julius AI. You just go on their website, you just sign up, and it takes you directly to their interface. We can see that we have a main chat. You can add a file in here. You can choose the model that you want to work with. You can choose advanced reasoning, extend memory, and you can even look at other notebooks and other things that people have done. You can find all your threads here in one place, your notebooks. You can even collaborate with your team and everything. So let's start from the basics, and we can start with a new project. So you just click in here, upload the file. We're just gonna go, I have this medical insurance file. It will start analyzing it very briefly, and you can see within seconds, we can see the table, and it even gives us what's the purpose of this data set. Within a few seconds, it says that the file contains medical insurance data, including age, sex, BMI, number of children, smoking status, and so on. And even says that this data can be used to analyze factors influencing insurance costs. By just putting the data, it already gives us all this information, and we haven't yet prompted anything. So we can start by giving it a first prompt, and it's a very simple prompt that we can just input in here. And it says, you're a data analyst working on a medical expense data set. Start by exploring the data to understand the distribution and relationship between variables. The variables are all these columns that we have in here. Step one, we want to do exploratory data analysis, or EDA, in which we want to see the summary in terms of statistics. We want to plot the distributions. We want to do a box plot of expenses by smoker, sex, and region, and then do a correlation heat map to see what features affect the most the expenses themselves. So we just click and we let Julius AI run. You'll notice here on the right side, we have this element here, this menu that has a few options. It has the outline, it has the notes, it has the reasoning, and the data explorer. So anything that happens along the way in your analysis will appear in here. And afterwards, you can just go back and look at all the things that you've done, and you wanna even see the logic that Julius AI used if you wanna tweak anything. So for now, we're just gonna focus on the code that we're having. As you can see, Julius AI is using Python to solve this analytics for us. And along the way, it shows us the reasoning and everything that it's doing. So we can wait just a few seconds and it will give us the final output in here. And here it is. As you can see, we get an overview of the data, 1300 rows, all the features. It's also giving us a summary of the statistics, the mean value, the standard deviation of each and every one of these. It's the distribution of the sex, the smoker. We have a good distribution between male and female, so no bias in here. The location, southeast, southwest, and so on. You can see beautiful visuals on the distribution, the age distribution in the data, the BMI distribution of the data, the medical expenses as well, the number of children. So these are all important variables. Here we looked at the expenses by categorical variable, and we can clearly see already that here being a smoker does affect the medical expenses very much. We can see here by sex, we can see that male have a tendency to pay more in medical expenses. And in terms of region, we can see some slight variations overall. So this is just a first look that we're having here. We can also look at the correlation heat map in here, and we can see expenses have the highest correlation with smokers. So this gives us a really interesting overview, an initial overview of the data. And here we have a pair plot, so we can see each feature, how it correlates with one another, compared here and grouped by smoker, because it's the one that has the highest correlation with the medical expenses. So this was the first phase. We can do step two now, and in step two, we can answer some business questions. So we want to know the top drivers of medical expenses. We want to know how much on average do smokers pay versus non-smokers, and are there any noticeable regional differences in expenses? So these are things that usually a data analyst would try to answer via analytics, via visualization, And these are the things that your stakeholders or your manager will be asking you to extract from the data itself. And Julius will do all this for us. It's just a matter of prompting the right way and just not rushing. When you put on a lot of steps at once, you might end up results that aren't the best because you need to keep guiding it. Sometimes there are some complexities, some nuances, and you need to add your own input sometimes so that you get the best analytics possible. And what's really cool is that we can see all the code generated by Julius AI, so we can even track the reasoning and everything. And by changing the model, we can also have different types of output, different types of reasoning. So it's really worth exploring and experimenting with this. And here we have it. Just within a few seconds, we have our business questions answered. So we have three questions. We can see that smoker is the feature that correlates the highest with the medical expenses. And you can see here, it says that the top drivers of medical expenses. And we can see here that clearly being a smoker is the highest one. The others are very low or not really interesting. So it says here that smoking status is by far the most significant driver of medical expenses, with smokers paying an additional $23,000 on average more than people that don't smoke. So that's quite scary, something to keep in mind. On average, how much do smokers pay vs non-smokers? We can see these are the averages, and the difference is what smokers pay more. So it's 280% more medical expenses for people that smoke compared to people that don't smoke. We can see it here nicely visualized. And looking at the regional differences, we can see that the mean value of each region, they're quite similar, I would say between 12 to 14,000. So I wouldn't say that that's a major factor, even though we can see in the southeast is a little bit higher than the southwest or northwest, but I think that's a little bit of a random one and it's not really worth exploring in our case. But here Julius AI even pushes it further and compares smokers versus non-smokers in each and every one of the regions, if that's something that interests you and your analysis. And you have a nice summary here that answers your questions within just one, two sentences. And that's amazing. That's what you kind of send to your stakeholders with the appropriate visuals as well. So now let's go to step number three. And in step number three, we want to build a predictive machine learning model. And in our case, since we want to build a model that can predict the medical expenses, and medical expense is a continuous value, which means we're going to do a regression model. And that's what we put in here, train a regression model to predict expenses using the other variables, show the feature importance and coefficients, evaluate the model, and create a simple UI form so that we can input some numbers. And let's give it to Julius AI to do it for us. And here it is again. After a few minutes, we have here predictive modeling analysis. Julius AI has tested three different machine learning models that we have for regression. It tested the linear regression, the random forest as we asked, and gradient boosting. And we can see here in terms of R square, we have the gradient boosting that has slightly better output and result than random forest. It's visualized in here. Usually in machine learning, it's really good to do test different models to see which ones perform better on your data. And here is showing the importance of each and every feature. We can see smoker, BMI, then age. This is in a descending order. It's interesting to focus only on the ones that have a real impact. Interactive expense predictor, the tools use. We have here predicted expenses with a similar profile. So this is the performance of our machine learning model. And you can see here that it even saved for us this model in a .pkl file, which is usually something that we do in machine learning. And if you just go and open that one, it will take you to this section on the left that has my files. And in this section, all the saved files, either that you've entered or that Julius AI gave you, are all saved in here. So you can go back to them and just refer back to them. And finally, let's say we want to add a final step. And this one will be more of a reporting. So we just say step four, report the output. We want to summarize the findings clearly. We want to highlight the 2-3 surprising or interesting insights, make all relevant charts clear and labeled, and keep everything clean and professional. Let's run this. Okay, so as you can see here, we have our medical insurance cost analysis final report. It's giving us an executive summary. It's bringing all relevant plots here, showcasing the effect of being a smoker, Also here is showing us the feature correlation and distribution, the key findings in here, the relationship between BMI and medical expenses, being a smoker, the age, surprising insights. You can see here smoking has an overwhelming impact, BMI significant influence, and some conclusions in here. And it even gives you the files used, the TXT file, the PNG, the picture, the HTML, and the JSON. And if you want to ask it to give you a PDF, you can just prompt it and it can generate a PDF version for you that you can go and download. It's as simple as this. It took us a few minutes to do a full analysis that usually a data analyst will take 2 days to do or 3 days to do, depending on what we're looking for and the complexity of the data. Obviously, you can go more complex and more detailed. It's all about prompting, saying the right things, and Julius AI is here to assist you in your data analytics project. And if you want to go and test Julius AI, just go on their website, julius.ai, and you just go here, do try Julius for free. There is no credit card or debit card asked, so you can just sign up and go try it. And if you enjoy it, then you can subscribe to a higher paid or a subscription like I do with them, because it's honestly saving me hours every week. So if you enjoyed it, give it a try and let me know in the comment section what you think of it, and see you on the next video.